Hi, I'm Tim Moss with Custom Guns, Ammo and Repairs. Today what we're doing is we're taking an Encore that's got a 45-70 barrel. We're going to break it down and we're going to make this a smokeless muzzleloader. We're going to install a Hankins breech plug, and then we have an Encore, no, we have an Encore, we have a Shockwave muzzle brake that we're going to install on the Encore. So this is 24. The pitch is 24 threads per inch. So we're gonna thread this, bore this out, countersink it, thread it, and we'll get started.
The trick is make sure the thing spins true, which is a big pain.
Around?
Yeah.
That's how far off it is.
Oh, okay.
Tighter.
Hold steady.
Oh yeah.
You see how it's spinning true?
Yep.
Low speeds. I'm cutting this stuff.
And I'll still turn it by hand.
It's straight. So I'm going to let that out.
The pressure we put on it making these threads has made it lose spinning true. /9/16.24. Ah, it's screwed in there really nice. All right, so the next thing we got to do is this action is not going to close because this breech plug is sticking out. So we need to recess this breech plug in far enough that it has room for the module to sit on top of it and the barrel closed with the receiver. That screwdriver up, it pushed this whole end up, which You guys know about leverage. It exerts a lot of leverage doing that. So we need to bring it back. But this is a hair tight. So we needed 0.468. We have 0.4655. Module's got a flush fit. So we have this side done. What we need to do is turn this barrel around and get our shockwave muzzle brake installed. The tap that we used to make the threads, we should put them back in. Pretty good.
Yeah.
Mm. But that's good enough for us. It'll work. It'll work fine.
just start. Should be getting close. Yeah, it's not like I forced that on, but I did not want to force it. It passes. This is the last one. You see, that's on this sturdy. That's it. Together. Reach plug in. So you have better luck putting this pin in when it's only parked. We're good. What I need to do is, I need to trim the ramrod down. That'll keep it from going around the modules. So, once I do that...
So, what we're going to do is, you see how that ejected? The CVA Scout V2s do the same thing. With every Scout that I do, I end up grinding this down from the other end. What I need to do is trim that up a little bit, and that'll keep it from going around the modules. So once I do that, I'll be anxious to shoot this gun. But we started out with a Thompson Center Encore. It had a 45.7 MGM barrel on it. And now we have a converted smokeless muzzleloader. This thing should shoot around 2,500 feet per second, push a 300 grain bullet about 2,500 feet per second. This barrel has a 1-20 inch twist, so the 300 grain Pitmans usually work pretty good out of a 1-20 inch barrel. So I'm anxious to shoot this and see how we do. I guess that'll be a day for another video. But for you guys that have been asking me the specifics on how do you convert a break open, that's how you convert a break open. So if you need a few pointers, feel free to give me a call and I'll tell you where I get some of my supplies. For you guys that don't do this on your own, we do this kind of thing all the time. So if you have a break open action, a Paramount, a Remington 700, any of that you want converted to a smokeless muzzleloader, give us a call and I'll be happy to talk to you and see what you want and see if we could work together to get one made for you.